In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this pretty cool, easy animated lower third inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we dive in, I just want to mention that if you're a patron on my Patreon page, you can download the MoGurt file already created for you inside Premiere Pro. I will link that down in the video description, so feel free to go grab it if you are an active patron on my Patreon page. Now let's dive into the tutorial. So I'm inside Premiere Pro, and the first step is I would recommend changing your workspace from editing to captions and graphics. This should display the essential graphics panel, which we'll be using quite a bit in this tutorial. The next thing I would turn on are your safe margins. You can find this in the program monitor, should be this icon here called safe margins. Click on this, this should display your safe margins. We wanna make sure that the text and graphics we create are inside the inner rectangle here. If you don't see this button here, you can always add it by clicking on the plus button and then clicking and dragging the icon down to your menu bar here. Once you have that, you can click okay. And once it's enabled, we can get started. So the first thing we'll create is our background plate for our name. So I'm gonna grab our rectangle tool here, and I'm just gonna simply click and draw out a shape. It can be roughly the correct size. We can always adjust it later, but once you create your shape, you should see it here. And inside Essential Graphics, you should see the shape name here. We can rename it, so we can double click on this and just name it name background. Since this will be the background that's underneath our name, we can change the color of it. So underneath appearance, we can click on the white tab here and we can change it. You can make it a solid color, but you can also choose gradients from the top left option. So in the example I showed, I used a linear gradient and I picked two shades of blue. On the left side, I'm gonna choose a darker blue color, something like that. And then on the right side, just a lighter shade of blue. Once you have that set, you can click okay. Once again, you can use your own colors, your own branding for this. Once you have that, the next step is to add in our text. So I'm gonna grab our type tool and then just click out once to create a new text layer. You'll see in the top right here, we have a blank text layer. We can type out the name of our subject. So in this case, I'm gonna type out my name, John the Video Guy. Then I'm gonna select the text by triple clicking inside the text bar here. And I'm gonna change the color by going down under appearance. I'm gonna change it to white and then click okay. And then for text, we have a few options here. You can change the font. So I'm using Futura and I'm gonna scale it up quite a bit. I'm also left aligning this, that way if I change it in the future, it's coming from the left-hand side. Next, I'm gonna grab our selection tool and then just realign this to our lower third. So I'm just gonna get this aligned here. I'm gonna size this down a little bit and just align accordingly here, probably to the center of our shape. All right, so once we have that, the next step is to create our info bar, or the bar that's underneath our name for like title information. To do that, I'm gonna simply click on the name background and duplicate it by hitting Command C and Command V. And then I can double click this and just name it title background. And then for this, I'm gonna change the color to a different color. I'm gonna go back to solid and make it white. Then I'm gonna click okay. And then with it selected, I'm just gonna adjust the size of it. So I'm just gonna click and drag to make it a little bit shorter of a bar. And then under Align and Transform, I'm just gonna align this right underneath the blue bar, right around there is good. Once we have that, the next step is to create our name. So to do that, I'm gonna click on the name and duplicate it by hitting, once again, Command C and Command V. And then we can click and drag this to the white area. I'm gonna double click on it and then change the color to black, or whichever color you prefer. And I'm gonna name this Content Creator Video Editor. I'm gonna select it and then just size this down quite a bit. Then I'm gonna grab my selection tool and just kind of align this accordingly. So you should have something that looks like this. You can make some fine-tune adjustments. So once you have your lower third looking like this, the next step is to animate it. Before we animate it, I'd like to group these different layers first. So for example, I'm gonna select, hold down shift and select the name background and my name. I'm gonna click on this create group button. This will just be the name. And then same thing with the title. I'm just gonna select these two layers and name this title. Now that we have that, we can start animating it. So the first thing I'm gonna do is add a transform effect to this graphic here. And to do that, I'm gonna go to the effects panel. If you don't see this window, you can always go up to window effects. And I'm gonna search for transform. Then I'm gonna click and drag this to our graphic layer in our timeline. And now what we can do is keyframe the position. So I'm gonna toggle on the position keyframe, go forward about 15 frames, make a keyframe here by clicking on this button, go back to the first one, and then just click and drag the value to the left. the first value there. That'll slide it to the left. And then if we click and play this back, you can see what we have. Now I'm gonna click and drag this out a little bit so it's a little longer. And what we can do is add some easing so it's a little bit more smooth. So to do that, I'm gonna right click on this last keyframe, go to temporal interpolation and go to ease in. You'll notice that it changes to an hourglass. And then we can fine tune it by clicking on this down arrow and then just click and drag this handlebar to the left a little bit. And that'll add some nice easing to this effect. So it kind of rests in place a little bit easier. The other thing we want to animate is our info bar. So to do that, what you can do for any of these elements is animate the group separately. So that's why I grouped them. Let's say if we want to just adjust the title position and animate it over time, we can click on that group, scroll down inside effects controls, and then what I'm going to do is go back to the end keyframe there, and then toggle this position keyframe by clicking on this stopwatch, go out a few seconds, make a keyframe, go back to the first one, and then what I'm gonna do is slide it up so that way it's kind of revealing underneath the name. Now what you do have to do is just readjust the layering of these layers. So back inside Essential Graphics, just make sure the name is above the title. That way it's hidden underneath the name. And once again, with these keyframes, we can add some easy ease. So we can right click on this, go to temporal interpolation and go to ease in. So when we play this back, it should look like this. All right, once we have that, the next step is to animate it off. So at the very end, I'm just gonna go to the end of our graphic here. I'm gonna make a keyframe next to position. I'm gonna go back a few keyframes. So I'm gonna hit the back arrow a few times, make a keyframe. And this time I'm gonna go down. So I'm gonna click and drag the second value here and just go down like that. And once again, we can click on this handlebar and just kind of ease out of that keyframe. So it kind of looks something like that. That's a little quick. We can also adjust the timing a little bit so it's a little bit more smooth. So it should look something like that. So in the end, this is what we have. Comes in, animates down, hangs there for a little bit, and then it slides off. One last thing I wanted to cover in this tutorial is, say if you needed to adjust the timing of this lower third, you want to make it longer or shorter, you can add some safe regions to these keyframes. So what you can do, I'm going to go full screen here on the effects controls panel by clicking on the tilde button. You'll notice at the very top, you'll see this little blue icon right there at the top left. You can click and drag this out over your keyframes, and this essentially adds protected regions to this area. Same thing with the last keyframe here. And click and drag out this, and this will just protect those keyframes. If we go back, say if we click and drag this clip to make it longer, you'll notice that the keyframes automatically adjust to the new timing. Even if we make it shorter, you can see the keyframes automatically come in. You don't have to readjust the keyframes every time you retime the graphic, essentially. So that's a helpful tip there. So that's how to create that pretty cool lower third graphic. If you want to learn more about Premiere Pro, there's several tutorials on my channel. I'll link one that you might like right up there. But that does it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.